I would like to talk a little bit about the Chilean situation in political terms and in the economy. Our authorities, they say that we are in a normal situation, but the numbers say other things. So we need support from the international media to come to Chile and see our reality, because we have the largest distribution of income is the largest in the world, and also we have a social injustice which is reflected in the wages of salaries for the poor people and the workers. And also, if you see the people that work in Congress, they earn a huge amount of money, but they when they need to raise the salaries for the wages for the labor people, they never do that. They only increase 5%, but when they need to increase their salaries in the parliament, they increase so highly, and the economy is managed by the people that own the industry, which is around 10 families, and also that doesn't allow people like me, which I'm running as a president, as an independent, does not allow me on open doors to be on the TV or to be on different media, newspapers, because I am really a persona non grata for the people that works in Congress and the political parties, and also to the people that owns the country, which are basically 10 families, and they make our life very miserable compared to the other people, because the cost of living in Chile is very high for what the people earn. So I would really appreciate if we can get more attention in Chile, the media. I invite the media to come to Chile. They can interview me, and I could tell them, you know, what is really going on in our country. The only good thing we are doing right now is the vaccine that we have like 30% of the population with the vaccine for the COVID, for the pandemic. But people unemployed in Chile is not 12% as the government is saying, it's more or less 60% of the family. I don't know what they want to do with that, but we really need to have the presence of the international media to come here and see what is really going on. Thank you very much.